can't just snap my fingers and make a plane. Believe me, I wish I could. Right now, we needed one. Bad. When we were coming over on the boat, I remember seeing an aircraft carrier. That gave me an idea. The Admiral Anderson. The name of an old sailor. When the first drone started attacking, the ship wasn't ready for battle yet. It was still in the dock, getting all rigged up. So they rushed to get her ready. I knew about Anderson. In the previous Ocean War, he was the commander of a ship that sent out the last fleet of jets. They say the deck was sloping so bad as it sank, the last plane barely made it off. Those fighters ended the war. That story gives me a little bit of hope, especially at a time like this. We're all in the same boat, like it or not. If this war keeps going on like it is, it'll be the end of everything. The military loaded this thing to the rafters with planes. Some were fighters that were going to be delivered to bases in occupied territory. It was hit before it could complete the mission. Jackpot. The hangars were loaded with goodies. This scrap queen's got work to do.
Trigger, everyone, listen up. The operation was a success. Erujian defense forces have been neutralized, and all Arsenal birds are down. However, those two new drones buzzing around have royally screwed up our plans. The Ocean and Erujian Coalition's air forces are in a sorry state thanks to them. We might not even have any viable aircraft. According to the Scrap Queen, the drones are trying to use the space elevator's transmission capabilities to send their data to drone manufacturing plants across the continent. They're trying to strengthen their numbers. What's worse, their data contains a depth of war experience, so the newer aircraft will be more tactically effective. If that's the case, this war will never end. We need to take both drones down, no matter what it takes. We'll do it. So we have homes to go back to. Well, the Scrap Queen's on our side. She says she can make any aircraft fly. This is our final mission. Trigger, let's go. We've got a goddamn war to end.
Affirmative. And I think everybody here knows the score. We all know who to follow. Commence mission. All aircraft follow trigger.
Roger that.
Understood.
All right.
Understood. Roger.
The space elevator is able to broadcast and communicate. With the information infrastructure down, it's the only place capable of wide area data transmission. The drones are waiting for it to power up again.
Clever little bastards.
Goal leader to Longcaster. UAV is confirmed in direction of travel. Engaging ship Bandit.
All aircraft converge on Skull Squadron. Surround and shoot them down.
Strider 3, copy. Let's see what we
UAV reacting. Damn, they're fast. All aircraft stay sharp. Intercept now. The UAVs are equipped with laser weaponry. Watch where their nose is pointing.
No, I'm a rocket ball. It touched. Go through, get out of there. I'm in there.
Salamander 3, Skull 2, lost. Damn it, that was quick.
I've never seen anyone fly this fast. Provide support.
Friendly lost. Another confirmed down.
Damn it. Trigger score hit. We can do it. Aim well and shoot him down.
Good. The enemy is still flying normally, though. Keep pushing. The damage has to be adding up.
Aiming him unit from just like a BI. Complete copies of my eye. We've received some serious upgrades. See, separate unit and unit.
It's a furlough. All right, watch for escape lanes.
Another hit. We're the only one getting anywhere out here.
Attention, all aircraft. Launch detected from UAV. They're small drones.
These guys have quite the bag of tricks.
Missile launched.
Oceans and Arusians, let's fly home. Bend in position.
Target hit, target hit. Damage confirmed, but those suckers are tough.
I've never seen them before.
Stay calm. Avoid friendly fire.
Strider 3.
There we go. One down. One down. Target is losing altitude rapidly.
The enemy is black smoke billowing from it. I saw it myself. Three strikes is a real deal. One point left.
Soul 2. Evade. Evade.
Just like me, please.
Soul 2 lost. It was a good one, too.
Vito. Damn it. Damn it. Is it just me, or is that
thing trying to read Trigger's reactions.
It's observing Strider 1. It's like it's trying to learn from him.
I need to get away. 3 cases!
One target left. We can do this. Count, give me your status.
Alive.
Excellent, so you're both okay.
Whoa, what makes you think that?
No time to explain, the radio will cut out soon. It'll take a short time for the drone to send over the data. You need to destroy it as fast as you can.
There it is, UAV spotted, we finally found it. is turning. It'll send its payload. Shoot it down, Trigger. It's down. Until I have less fuel, but I have no choice. Attempting to land. I don't think my plane will make it. Anyway, here goes. Come on, baby, stay with me just a bit more.
Unknown. The path to mankind's vast future remains standing, Granddad. The refugees built the settlement for themselves at the base of the space elevator. A humanitarian mission from Yuktuvania airdropped some supplies for them again today. Thanks to the princess, the whole world was pitching in to help these people. Handing out the relief supplies would have been a perfect gig for that anarchist dude. But since he's dead now, the job went to the guy from Belka, George. I guess Tabloid got that new system he wanted in the end. Mihai's granddaughters are helping out too. Mihai. That cranky old geezer's here with us too.
I never wanted to create anything, and now here I am, clinging to life. Watching as my grandchildren and their generation make a new future for themselves and the world. Is this my punishment then? All I do is lie here, wasting away. I'll never know the freedom of flying the open skies ever again. I've been grounded, and my wings have been clipped.
You know what having peace in the world means? It's being able to die in your own bed at a ripe old age. Peace is what those girls are working so hard for here. We got a bunch more refugees today. And the princess? She's looking to the stars. Dark blue. To the heavens and beyond.
Can you hear me?
Tu te souviens de nos fleurs préférées qui chantaient tout près de nous du jour de ta déclaration?